Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of our last game of the night for the Dreamhack DOTA 2 competition, where we now have Uebelst going up against TCM Gaming, our two bottom teams as far as Group B goes. But hey, the other game's already been broadcast, so we make sure that you guys at home can keep up to date with all of your DOTA 2 coming out from Dreamhack. So let's jump ourselves inside the game and see who can at least claim that third position here in Group B. Will it be Uebelst or TCM Gaming? Pretty sure Uebelst are going to be feeling pretty down after that last game. I don't know. What do you think, Clairvoyance? Do you think Uebelst can pick themselves up after that kind of animage display?
Oh yeah. If there's anything out of LAN, it's the fact that you have all your teammates beside you, and a lot of teams, especially in this LAN setting, will find the spirit. You know, there goes the saying that discouragement is just another form of encouragement. And honestly, they want to win. I think neither one of these teams, I know this is kind of like consolation for a lot of viewers, especially because neither teams will advance, and it's quite unfortunately so. However, it's good to take home a victory on your LAN. And for these guys, from what I know, this is one of their first LANs, right? Maybe, yes?
These guys have actually been around a while. They have actually played around in a lot of different LANs across Germany. Because a lot of these guys have been playing for a very, very long time. I believe this actually... I know this is Alex's at least second trip to DreamHack. Because he was there with Mousesports last time they went. And as far as RMN goes, I think he was a stand-in for one of the other teams that went to DreamHack. But yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Uebelst definitely has some experience there. And TCM Gaming, man, you kind of know. You kind of know they've been there. They're Swedish. So if you're Swedish and you know DreamHack, then something is wrong.
Well, regardless, I really hope that doesn't discredit my point regarding a victory. And I think it's important. There is a lot on the line, so to speak. And let's see if they can bring their A game to prove that.
Well, let's give her a shot, man. Let's give her a shot. TCM, you got two pickups. Uebelst has already managed to grab the Darkseer. Starting off with two bans with the Gyro as well as the Magnus. So obviously looking to slip some extra things through. This means Lifestealer. This means Prophet. Might have also been looking to see if Go Audio wanted to play ball with him and leave either the Wisp or the Batrider through. And, well, you know what? Lifestealer or Prophet, both the two I mentioned, not being picked up by TCM. They're going to go with the SD, and they also go with the Queen of Pain.
Well, I think the heroes you mentioned are absolutely fine. I mean, the fact that the Magnus ban is there, that hero has been getting absolutely zero mention so far in the tournament. So when Uebelst bans Magnus like that, for me, it's either a misclick or a wasted ban. And like rightfully so, because when you waste a ban and your first or second, like depending on whichever pick, it has different implications. But as you said, like the heroes, Lifestealer, Nature's Prophet, both making it past, and it makes sense so far. I mean, if you want to offer the Shadow Demon and Queen of Pain so early, then you're going to have the cat like Nyx Assassin picked up to counter you, and there's no denying that. But there is still the Lifestealer in the pool, and Prophet is also still a very viable option. Both teams have set themselves up for a pretty nice draft. And with the puck getting banned out, yeah, I guess TCM has the first pick on those two, first dibs.
So I had nothing intelligent to say, so I just stayed quiet.
Oh, come on, Toby. You don't have to have anything intelligent.
I don't know, man. I don't know. Viewers at this time of the night, this is when those threads start up with the quote saying, oh my, like Toby said, a gem's worth 700. Yes.
Oh, you're actually recalling that one, huh?
Oh, I knew it the second I said that. But when you're going through a match, you try to keep momentum, you don't want to always go back and say, you know what? Got to correct something there. It's not actually worth 700 gold anymore, is it? No, it was changed.
Well, Toby, this is...
Sorry, it used to be worth 600.
Oh, Toby, come on now. You're getting marked for this, please. Keep your composure. This is just an examination. This is not DreamHack.
It's just an examination. Why does it feel like anal probing?
I won't go into that specifically for very obvious reasons.
Yeah, because it's disgusting.
Sorry,
obvious reason, but Captain Obvious right here. next ban, Go Audio. How many times have we seen this Keeper of the Light now banned out? We haven't had one game with Keeper of the Light. I think we've had four games banned and like zero games played with him.
Yeah, I think it's just all dependent on catering to the styles of these specific teams. I mean, the most interesting Keeper ban to me was the fact that, well, it's to synergize with Nyx, so that's understandable. But The most interesting keeper ban was so far, the note that we made about VP, how it's a hero that kind of just, it really nullifies their playstyle. So here, once again, it's understandable because you don't want it to combo up with the Nyx Assassin. It's just such a fantastic support combination with the recall, global presence, as well as Nyx Assassin potentially being anywhere. And speaking of combos, TCM has just found theirs, Toby.
Yeah, everybody loves the Kunkka these days, especially the Swedes. So we got SD and Kunkka coming their way, which gives a little bit more flexibility as far as their lanes go. Normally, I'd say then you could open up your middle lane with this. But with the Queen of Pain already up there, unless Uebelst is very obviously going to go for a defensive or aggressive trial, unless Uebelst is most definitely going to go for an aggressive try lane, I would actually assume Kunkka and SD to head north. And the reason I say that is because I was also thinking about them being the middle lane, but heading north and going up against an aggressive try lane with something like a Latrak or a Lina is very simple to do. And then your Queen of Pain can run bottom lane up against a Darkseer or the middle lane. There's still many, many options here, but you need to run an aggressive try lane if you can have Queen of Pain going up against a Darkseer on bottom. It's just that simple. Right.
Yep, and you know what? With the Enchantress pick, I think the illusions of the aggressive trialing out of TCM has semi been shattered, because Kunkka and Shadow Demon, while it's a fantastic combination and they do still have the potential Leshrac or whatever burst they want to add onto the plate available for them, Enchantress walking out with the with a jungle creep and killing one hero is going to just completely shut down that trialing. So we have seen the aggressive trialings from Kunkka and Shadow Demon before. We've also seen Kunkka go to the mid lane, but as we said, as you mentioned, with the Queen of Pain, it's unlikely. Mm-hmm. And then the only thing that's left, if those are the cases, is the Kunkka on the safe lane, to which it's actually not my favorite, but Darkseer is going to get zoned out pretty heavily against three heroes, as always. So it's something to look forward to.
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing Go Audio's pick. Does he just say, like, let's throw caution to the wind? Let's just say, Clairvoyance is wrong. Let's just run top lane, you know? We can do it. I believe in miracles. Do ya?
No, we were talking about, believing in the lobby. And I don't know, man. I'm not sure if you have credibility to say that.
I don't believe in the lobby. After what I believe was 2 hours... today that we've been sitting here waiting between games, I don't believe in the lobby anymore.
Hey man, I told you, whether they allocate 10 minutes or an hour or 10 hours, it's a LAN. It's always going to be delayed, and you should have known this. You experienced it far more times.
I know this. That's why I brought snacks.
Ah, okay. Well,
I came prepared, peoples. I came prepared. If you ever, for people out there watching at home, if you ever watch a LAN event, make sure you have something to keep you entertained, like have I don't know what else can you have? Like have a robot chicken playing on a side screen. Have a girl over your place. If you can't find yourself a girl, then blow one up. And I'm not talking like detonation. I'm talking like other kind of.
Blow. All right, Toby. Let's move on with life on that one.
Yeah.
The Clockwork pickup, once again, a fantastic setup for the team fight. I've actually lost to a lineup that consisted of exactly these four heroes plus one. I can't recall exactly what that extra hero was, but this is a really powerful lineup coming out of TCM Gaming. Believe it or not, these heroes have incredible amounts of synergy between them. Mm-hmm. The team fight potential coming out of these heroes, as well as Clockwork, I vaguely remember I had a Magnus in the game that I played against this specific lineup, and we got rolled. Oh yeah, now I remember. I picked Alchemist against Kunkka because I think Alchemist is such a fantastic hero. But with regards to the carry, the Phantom Assassin is the choice of Uebelest Gaming. So they'll go with that, and they have the Enchantress in the jungle with Nyx Assassin probably babysitting. It's possible that he goes to the mid lane against Queen.
I'm hoping this is aggressive tri lane. I really, really, really like this from TCM to go aggressive. They've got so much. It's positioning would be so badly punished with Enchant and a Stifling Dagger. You got so much slow there that it basically counts as a stun. And then you've actually got a stun from the Nyx Assassin. If you control even like a slightly decent creep with the SD, that can really turn on you. If he disrupts someone to try and save them, then you just will just throw out another Stifling Dagger, or you'll have probably Enchant off cooldown, depending on the timing, like the length of the initiation.
Right, right. It might as well turn into Uebelist initiation with the disrupt.
Yeah, let them actually take the front foot forward. Enchantress is great at moving through the jungle, most definitely. And then pushing out towers is an iffy kind of thing. Like Nyx and PA, they won't be as effective with that one. But diving on towers when you've got repositioning abilities like the PA and you've got Enchantress creep to help tank up, hell yeah. That's why, like, yeah, take out the Visage. Definitely take out the Visage. That's just in case, again, possibility of aggressive trialing by TCM. But this is going to come down to so much, like, vision of laning very early on. A Darkseer up against a Clockwork. Darkseer, he'll have a rough time. He's got to keep his distance so he doesn't get mana burned out, which makes it difficult to get in there and get last hits. But at the same time, Clockwork's still going to need some good regeneration to deal with those Iron Shells. Lina will be the final one, so it is going to be the TCM aggression.
Mm-hmm.
Does it, though, come on the bottom lane at the start and then having Lina and SD rotate? Or do Ubel say, you know what, let's just have like a friendly agreement. You run your defensive tri lane. We run our aggressive tri lane, and may the best team win.
Yeah, it's definitely something that'll have to pan out as the heroes get picked. But
did you also notice too there was no fifth ban from TCM?
Oh, you know what? Yeah, because they had 0 seconds on the bonus timer. I think they must have missed it.
Yeah, I'm guessing so.
Yeah.
But the bounty hunter, they're just like, yeah, screw it. We don't need a ban. That's all good.
So the bounty hunter is the pickup, and we're actually going to get the Queen versus Darkseer matchup, except it's not going to be in the lane we had predicted it to be. It'll probably be in the mid lane now, with the Clockwork going up against the bounty hunter. And I feel like Uebelst Gaming actually has pretty good lanes. And the funny thing is, their lineup, in my opinion, is not that strong. Their synergy isn't the most fantastic. They've got a lot of good base rush heroes in a sense that Alex can pop up from nowhere along with Sky. PA, as you said, repositions extremely fast with a couple of clicks of a couple of buttons. And Enchantress having that early force within the jungle, you know, you can always be a potential threat with the right creep. So I feel like TCM Gaming, if they do get caught out in an aggressive tri-lane, it is going to be dangerous. But you cannot undermine the power of the Shadow Demon Lina Kunkka combination. That is seriously just a one-click death combo. If SD gets a disrupt on a single hero, anyone in this game, they'll be able to burst them down at level 1. So, needless to say, Uebelst has to be very cautious.
Well, let's see how much caution they've got. Running through our lines, it is going to be an aggressive tri-lane coming in from TCM. So we'll have Utsa heading towards the top lane as the SD. Werner is the Clockwork gone behind him. Go Audio will be the Kunkka. Actually, they are starting to switch. Blueberry Ninja heading up north as the Queen of Pain and Hawaii O.O. as the Lina. All five heroes, in fact, heading up north, apart from Werner. Werner doesn't like north, he likes south. As far as Uebelst goes, we're going to have Alex as the next assassin supporting RMM Darkseer. So mid lane player, he will be heading there. And Edie will be heading into the jungle as the Enchantress. His own jungle, of course, not an aggressive tri lane. And he'll be up here making sure Blue Banana gets some good farm. While on the bottom lane, Bounty Hunter will be making a nuisance of himself. And that will be played by Sky.
Wow. This is really smart rotations coming out of TCM, and they don't even know it, but it's just natural. When you see the BH, you'll assume that it goes to the long lane. And Queen of Pain versus Bounty Hunter, Toby, that matchup, it's not fair for the Bounty. The Shadow Strike is just a spell that completely decimates a Bounty Hunter in the lane, so the fact that you can spam it on Queen of Pain means that this Bounty Hunter is probably going to get zoned out within, I would imagine, about 2 minutes. He only has one stack of Tangles. That's not going to be enough for his sustainability in the lane. And that's going to be one lane that TCM has already secured in their favor.
We're going to go cool style. I want the Frozen Touch. I love the share ability. Actually, Frozen Touch looks cool. But is Tempest Wing even better? Sorry.
Toby, you're right, bro.
I can just steal everyone's touch.
Well, I'm glad you're excited for this game. It's going to matter a lot for these boys.
We accept what this game is. It's a dead rubber. So everyone gets to have a little bit of fun. Everyone gets to have a little bit of fun. There's no pressure. There's just good Dota. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about.
Yeah, and TCM supports. They're not wasting any time. Already blocking up the pull without even the usage of wards. So that's very good conservative move on them. The PA is going to try to farm with the Stifling Dagger, but at level 1, it's basically a right click. It's just not enough at certain points. Mm-hmm. And yeah, as the lane gets pushed back, this is going to be heavily in favor of TCM Gaming. So I think the top lane, that's pretty secure. Meanwhile, the bottom lane is
disruption.
Just
Torrent actually found a space for it. Lifestrike Array will chain up, but PA, there's going to be an extra stun here from Alex just to give a little bit of space to the blue banana. He's going to have to either use his tangos or he decides south.
Yeah, it was very good to take that off of him so early. Now, once again, he can't do the same thing in terms of staying alive and just trying to stay in the lane afterwards.
Ooh, a tornado. So, they need a stun to stop this. Hawaii are always going to get over here and kill off that Wilkin. Or else I'll have this tornado for the next 40 seconds. Or in this case, 26.
Yeah, this tornado is going to do a lot of work. No doubt about that. You know, the funny thing about this tornado, though, is actually, never mind, because TCM has successfully pulled the creep wave into the right jungle. Because if that wasn't the case, yeah, they're pushing the lane right now, and that's not the best, but Blue Banana, he's not going to miss out on EXP just because the creep wave is being pulled.
Yep. That actually makes it a little bit more difficult right now for Alex as well as Blue Banana to get these last hits in. Kanka's still not having a great time, but just waits for the tornado to end. And now, he'll pop the salve if they take care of the creep wave. In fact, I think he still managed to get almost every single last hit underneath that tower, being 7-4 now. And there goes his salve. So all's well that ends well for TCM. How's the bottom lane looking? So Blueberry Ninja 9-4 up against the wait, Clockwork's losing a lot of life points. I thought it was for something else. I just saw its HP bar just drop very drastically.
Yeah, yeah. It's the Iron Shell under the tower, so it makes sense. Darkseer, if he doesn't get close, as you said, he will have free reign.
Lifestrike Array's got to go first. Torrent could be the secondary one here. And there actually is no secondary one. Kanka's too far away. Now he will... He throws out the Torrent just over towards the side, but it is the first blood from the top lane. Has to go down. And now Stifling Dagger. There is Blink off cooldown in 1 second time. And now Blue Banana can jump if he wants to. Lifestrike Array holds Alex out. There's no follow-up stun. As well as that slave, Alex has to be careful with this low life points he's got. But he's also got himself this wonderful thing called a salve. And go audio, he wants Regions Ursa. He can't keep up with it though. 320 movement speed against 300. Who wins in that foot race?
Yeah, the Ursa is pretty fast compared to heroes without boots.
Snipe off middle lane. Region, if he pops invis and walks middle lane right now, he would have Stumpy. And he's not going to get him. He wants to kill the middle lane. He's going to walk so close to this line so he doesn't get seen. He got seen.
Yeah, he got seen. I don't think they would have killed Werner either way. I mean, the cogs are so good.
Really? They're giving it a shot, man. Iron Shell up on both of them. That's going to be a double. Werner almost able to kill off Sky. Goes back invis. A battery assault not making it easy for him. And now SD comes in. What's he going to go point in? Shadow Poison.
Oh, you know what I thought? I thought he was actually going to walk to the edge of that cliff there as he gets level 2. Throw out the Shadow Poison. If he's made the snipe, that would have been a huge play.
Yep. I was looking for exactly the same thing, man. But no huge play in this game. In the meantime, though, Queen of Pain, again, still free farming. Our second free farming Queen of Pain we've seen today.
Yeah, it's just, honestly, there's nothing that a bounty hunter can do. Once again, he's walking back to base. He's got 430-something gold. He wants his boots. I'm not sure if he's going to commit to regen. It'd be wise to do so. It'd be really, really good for him to stay in the lane and get EXP. But as it is, he actually sold his branch just to get boots. And man, this is going to be really hard for this bounty hunter now.
Yeah. No consumables whatsoever. I'm surprised someone's not buying some for him. So he can actually go out there and do something.
Yeah. Werner actually bought dust for himself.
Huh.
Yeah. That one rotation forced that out of him. He said, I'm not going to deal with you anymore. It's pretty funny.
It's one way to go with it. You want to gank him up, throw out the cogs, at least know what you're going to be fighting. And now he's got his ultimate up and running. It also means he can move around and start ganking. And Regen's back here again. Darkseer, Iron Shell, and DD. So, Initiation comes out by Sky. Regen shows himself, but he's also got no mana. He's got a bottle charge, but that doesn't mean he's got mana. He's got enough for a surge. And that's it. He's out.
Yep, he's actually walking towards the jungle. I'm not sure if it's to ferry the bottle away. Yeah, it is. So, he'll ferry the bottle away and try to maximize the efficiency of the courier's movement.
Well, empty bottle. Curry doesn't really have a lot of movement. 9 seconds, and it's just sitting there, basically. Starts to move, but he's still limping.
Yep. Sky has returned to the bottom. He's going to attack once. The Queen's going to probably Shadow Strike him. If he dodges it, that's really, really nice.
He dodged it.
Really, really nice. So but he can't do that very often, though.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't really cost Blue Bear Ninja that much. What, 100 mana out of almost 500 pull? And Sky forced back into the tree line. While Alex is trying to force TCM off this top lane. They're pulling again, but because the Dire Creep Wave was coming with it, it didn't take the full aggro of the Radiant Creep Wave. Just one of the melee creeps that comes in. And now Disruption. Torrent, follow-up, Hawaii O.O. too far away, and now Go Audio. He's very deep out of here. Enchantress with the Sun, the Lion Strike rail by a little bit of time, but he's still going to go down. Alex with the Spy Carapace has too many poison stacks up here on Region. Pull back in again. Go Audio able to get that kill, but Werne is now rotated up towards the top lane as well for TCM. Holds Region in position. And Go Audio, we kind of felt was already too far up, is actually going to live through this. Should live through this. Centaur, trying to do a crazy Ivan stomp. Not gonna work.
The Enchantress rotation was really good, but they lost the PA as a result of that gank. I'm not sure if that was entirely worth it for them, but regardless, the PA is back. She'll have a moment's breather as TCM are kind of just taking their wounds back to heal at the fountain.
Oh, Region, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't show yourself, Region. He knows he has to get himself back inside of his invis again, and if... He's so lucky that this is nighttime. If this wasn't nighttime, he would be dead right now.
Yeah, I didn't know which region you were talking about for a second.
Oh, God damn it!
Toby?
Talking about Sky on bottom lane. I am so gonna give Alex hell for this. The really sad thing is, I gotta give him hell for this, but I actually really like Region. When he was back part of Skorne, those are the good times, man. Those are the good times.
Mm-hmm. So, they're definitely showing their support, and I hope Region support showing his support to these guys as well. Because as it stands, you know, with the Queen of Pain at the highest on the CS board, it's frankly not looking too well for them. TCM, they're having a rotation to the mid, and forget that thought, because RMN is going to secure himself a haste rune at bottom. How conveniently so, this is going to be really, really good because he's that much closer to his, mech, as we speak.
Well, he just needs to get himself a ring of regen. He's got it. Mm-hmm. That is all he requires. One Iron Shell in the middle lane would do it, but he doesn't have mana for it. At the same time, he doesn't want to waste the haste rune either. So, decision time there, RMN. Decision time.
Oh, and this is a really clutch spot for Werne to find Region. If he saw him, he would have been able to... Oh, that is such a clutch spot. He would guarantee the kill if he went.
Now he's going to find Alex instead. Spy Carapace, dust already being done. And then Stifling Dagger jump in. Even track coming out from Sky. There's going to be a four-way. He almost brought down Alex and all of that. Now there's trouble for RMM. Disruption bought him time to get out, but Hawaii O as well as Go Audio will not be so lucky. Torrent unable to hit Hawaii O. Actually, a nice little juke around the tree line, cutting it out, then to the Light Strike Array, but Sky track is up. So a secondary track kill. Ship will fly. A lot of damage onto Sky. But it's two track kills with the entire team of Uebelst being involved in that.
Yeah, and something they very well needed, because now Nyx Assassin is rotating to defend this tower, but it's probably gone. And the Queen of Pain hastily backing out after the tower, sitting at 2k gold, returning to base probably to pick up some items. And I wonder what she's going to get. Is it going to be a BKB that she's forced into, or is she going to go for Orchid or damage items?
It's going to be BKB.
Yeah, there it is. She knows. Against the Nyx Assassin, Queen of Pain's... Actually, Nyx Assassin is pretty much the most direct counter to Queen of Pain you can get. And yeah, needless to say. For obvious reasons. I mean, you pop a Carapace and you try to Sonic Wave a Carapace, Nyx Assassin, all of a sudden you die. And you wonder what happened.
The other big problem is going to be what's going to happen with Nyx Assassin and Bounty Hunter. Like, BKB is great, but if you don't have yourself, like, if you're stunned and you can't trigger it, then BKB isn't great.
Pretty much.
Because you can't use the damn thing. I was almost wondering if Lincoln's Fear might have been an option for him as well.
It actually could have been. Now that you mention it, Lincoln's would have been a pretty good alternative. If with Queen of Pain Survivor, hold that thought, there's... No, that's just a casual disrupt. But Yeah, with Queen of Pain, the main survivability is either you either prevent everything with BKB, or you react fast enough. But hold that thought.
Latches in. Going in. RMN locked in, and then, well, he backed him out of the cog, so he didn't have to deal with that. But there's just too much damage coming up from Hawaii OO with a DD and the Scream Burst damage from Blueberry Ninja. Are they thinking about turning around? ED just evades. Regions coming in. There were sentry wards on the deck. They're going to need some new ones. But they still got the dust, actually, from the Clockwork Goblin. They weren't forced to use it in the middle lane. There we go. There's the new ones. Sentry wards coming in for the SD. Also, smoke. Wondering if they really want to try and kill somebody in all of this. Ninja's headed up towards the top lane. He's got an ulti, which we kind of are waiting for him to use. So, guessing Blue Banana. X marks the spot. Torrent, chain, ulti, burst damage, but then blink away the range creep. It's got very, very low on life, but then mech charge from RMN. Iron Shell, surge him up, bring him back in again. Alex already managed to get himself one stun, stifling dagger, gonna slow down Blueberry Ninja. Even with a blink away, the rest of Uebelst can keep up with him. There's already a coup de grace. And then Alex, secondary stun. Hold behind him. SD comes in with a disruption. Now Hawaii OO looking for the stun. Unable to get one. Alex underneath the tier 1 tower trying to fight this one. And Blue Banana able to finally kill off that Queen of Pain. But in comes Werne. In from the side. And this is going to be an absolute pit of death inside the cogs. Sky ticks out. Still at the same time, Edie's looking for a kill out in the SD. But they've already lost three. He's trying to move himself so he can avoid the torrent. But X marks spot into the torrent, cocks down, and Werner saving his team from a horrible scenario, making it into an absolutely wonderful scenario.
Yeah, that latch in with cogs, that was absolutely crucial for everything to happen there. Alex actually spent his time right-clicking a couple of illusions. I'm not too sure if he had just lost control and just forgot about us or something, but it was weird. Regardless, the nicest thing about that is while they were stuck inside the cogs, Sky was able to track up and shuriken toss to finish off the Lina, and that was a really nice pickup kill just before he said goodbye to this world. And yeah, it helps him in his process, because once again we know how difficult of a time he had in the early game.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, Regent's having himself some fun. Guess an illusion rune sends an iron shell down. Just that in itself's enough to be a pain in the butt. Sky.
Which region?
Sorry, damn it to hell! RMN! RMN! I'm no longer going to say their names, even though it was always one of those things that you should always try and do as a commentator so people can actually get behind the personalities of each player. but in this scenario, they're all dicks. And now, Blue Banana, he's going to go down the top lane. I said his name. Laguna Blade, well, that's a lot of damage, but it's not enough to finish him off. Ship comes in through the rear. Alex able to get that stun and mana burn. Torrent was not enough to end up killing off that PA, and now Bounty Hunter is actually having a lot of trouble as well in the bottom lane. Blueberry Ninja and Werne working together. And they're able to bring down the Bounty on the bottom lane. But they do lose their leaner on the top lane. And now middle. Darkseer, there's still an Iron Shell here, but that creep. Not looking too great in life, and neither is RMN. Has to run himself up to that 40-minute rune, and then all of a sudden, regeneration rune. As well as full bottle up his sleeve. So, yeah, looking good.
Pretty convenient. He almost walked straight into the clockwork. That would have been guaranteed death. Audio actually didn't X mark the spot, so I think he was just unprepared for it. But, yeah, he's looking pretty good right now with full HP and Iron Shell ready to go. So, this quote-unquote push that was about to happen at the mid lane, definitely getting delayed to an extent.
Sky just trying to back Blueberry Ninja out from this bottom tower. But he's waiting to get... There we go, denying the catapult. Doesn't fear being tracked. Sky can't really initiate on him. Queen of Pain's got more than enough life to survive this, and also the longer she stays here, now she can pick up a Mithril Hammer, and there's also... It's bait. It's just bait. There's smoke down here for TCM. Fortification being used, weren't they? Having a guess behind the tower. But now he's also revealed himself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a little bit inconvenient. And now that Sky's coming in, he sees Atzi as well on the Shadow Demon. So they'll have to do a full retreat. Now, RMN is inside the enemy jungle. I'm not sure what he's looking to accomplish. And there it is. He's just TPing back. He's going to hold off the tower with the Iron Shells.
I think he wanted to come in behind. I think he was looking to get actually Blueberry Ninja from by coming in behind. And if he had to wait a little bit longer, he would just farm up a little bit more. But then when the smoke reveal came out, instantly you know you can't do that. Because the odds are not in your favor. So your element of surprise to catch the blinking Queen of Pain is not possible.
Pretty much so.
Well, but maybe it's enough to kill off Darks here on the bottom lane. Blueberry Ninja, there goes your scream. Doesn't have enough mana for an ultimate. We're actually with 9-1 charges. It's going to come pretty damn close. In fact, we'll use it. No, still short. And now Clockwork latches down. Region, fucking Sky, caught out. Cog's just bumping Alex back out again. And Werner having a great time. Alex can come in and also, like, he can Vendetta and then stun. But there's just not enough follow-up anymore. Now he's lost the Bounty and the Darkseer.
Mm-hmm. Yep, so a smart move to retreat back. He had the mana boots. He barely had the mana if he had used it for his full combo. But regardless, once again, opting for the safe option. Right thing to do, as their PA, most importantly, is getting space to farm finally on the safe lane. I know TCM's always kept the hero or two up here. But, I mean, at this stage in the game, when PA is level 11, has the levels up in Blur and Phantom Strike, it's just so hard to take her down without the Queen. So, yeah. Blue Banana doing a good job staying alive and finding his farm everywhere he can.
He needs to, man. He really needs to. And TCM knows he needs to. They're bringing three heroes up here. Blueberry Ninja again. And actually, I'm kind of happy to see he's not going BKB. It's nice.
Cool.
Quap.
Oh, the Queen has changed. Oh, yeah. You know what? That's actually interesting. When you pick up the Ogre Axe first, you have the option for the Axe as well. But hold that thought. There's a double gank coming.
Yeah, Lightstrike Array, Laguna Blade as well. That's a lot of damage. Good time for the mech. Actually kept him alive when Blueberry Ninja jumped in for the scream. That could have been enough damage. And now he's caught in the back corner. Ulti is available. Four heroes all lined up. He's going to blink himself away. He just kept walking in the middle of the engagement. Almost like he DC'd out. Nice, Torrent. Where's the ship? No follow-up. Purge goes out on one, and now it's just Uebelst rolling with the punches. Blue Banana gets himself a double. And they will take this tier 1 tower on the top lane. Really, I was waiting for the Quap ulti to come out there. I was also waiting for Quap to blink into the river.
Yeah, she had a pretty good timing, especially when all the stuns were down. But as you said, she kind of just, what do you call that? Juked and jive. Yeah, went back and forth inside. A lot of iron shell damage as well as a whole bunch of heroes right-clicking her. Mm-hmm. And this is something that we had expected from the draft. Like, when you have the Bounty Hunter and you start picking up a little bit of kills, get a slight bit of momentum, there are a lot of heroes that just synergize with that face-rushing ability to just walk in and fight. PA and Nyx Assassin, both really, really good at that. Of course, the Darkseer as well.
Oh, Werner! You are such a dick! I don't know if you saw that, but Bounty Hunter,
that was rude.
He saw the regeneration rune and says, like, you know what? No, my Darkseer needs it. They get revenge on the leader on the top lane. But when I just walks in, steals the regeneration rune, kills off the Bounty Hunter as well, just adds salt to the wound.
Yeah, that was just rude. Mm. But they will get a tower out of this, so it was a very good play by him. Of course, the Lina did go down at the top lane, and MPA, once again, being the biggest.
Very smartly canceling that TP.
Yeah, that would have been.
Queen of Pain still got ulti up and available. She never used the damn thing. But now, she's actually got the full Aghanim Scepter. Probably good. Maybe this was her reasoning for not using it. Not quite sure of the reasoning. Maybe it is. Aghanims.
Yep.
Hearing Clockwork Latch. Nyx Assassin. Alice just goes down the battery assault.
Wow. Wernie's actually getting a lot of solo kills, just racking them up little by little. And it's helping them a lot because he's sitting here at 7-1-4. He has a mech as well as the urn charges. So when your Clockwork is this big, Uebelst with all of your single target heroes have to be really, really careful. Because right now he can snipe anybody except, you know, bar maybe the PA and the Darkseer. Mm-hmm. So yeah, it's definitely something that they have to keep in their minds as they rotate to the top lane, probably to take this tier 1 tower.
Well, Gaudio, we'll see if he's up to this task of defending it. Oh, already tracked and dead.
Oh, GG.
No way in all high hell. He throws out one last ship, does a little bit of damage, and then again, another TP that was coming in. Told to cancel. T1 tower on the bottom lane can still be fortified. As well, TCM takes out the T1 tower on the top lane, which has already been fortified. Actually, they don't. I thought they would try and make him wait a little bit longer.
Mm-hmm. Well, this PA almost has a BKB now, Toby. When he gets the BKB, all of TCM's damage is going to be completely negated. Like, there's nothing on TCM that does damage to a PA right now, maybe except the Kunkka, of which, you know...
Ooh, Alex, don't do it, man. Don't do it. She's not alone. You gotta know that scouting. She's not alone. And now he goes. Blink away before he can get the stun off. Casting animation time is way too long for that. But at least got the Vendetta damage in. And now Werner. No one will walk through the
corner. Oh, he found the Lina.
Caught in the corner. Last Striker Ray. And Alex already had his Spike Carapace up.
Yeah, and that was a track kill. So, once again, a very good sum of gold going for them. RMN finds two heroes of TCM. He's in Viz. Mm-hmm. And it's not going to accomplish anything, but he does have 2.8k gold in his bank.
Not looking too shabby, man. Not looking too shabby at all. One thing he should be careful of is the fact there is a gem flying out right now for the SD. But RMN might say, you know what, let's just go for this. If there was one other hero there, he would have backed walled and just said, let's go, Bush.
Yep, pretty much. And the BKB was coming in from PA. That might have actually been the reason why they didn't go right away. But Sky is here now. He should probably drop a track.
X mark spot. Torrent gonna hit here on the blue banana. Life Strike Array. Clockwork in from the side. What a very quick damage to kill off the PA. Regions on the run out as well.
Yeah, that was such an important kill. That burst was huge, and they had coordinated that perfectly. I think PA had an opening for the BKB, but probably wanted to conserve it because she didn't think it was gonna be lethal damage. But little to her knowledge, it was lethal.
Moving out right now. There's a DD rune up on that Queen of Pain. With Aghanim Scepter, anyone who leaves the base and is shown as solo after they go past that very aggressive Radiant Ward in the Dire Jungle. Bluebird Ninja will just jump on. It's rather interesting, though, that we have ninjas up against bananas.
Yes. It's not the arch enemies that you will see televised every single day. However, very, very formidable foes to each other.
Yeah, have you ever been attacked by a banana? You gotta learn to defend yourself against bananas, man.
Well, yeah, it's definitely scary sometimes, but, you know.
Shout out to people who actually understand what the hell I'm referencing. If you don't understand what I'm referencing, obviously you're too young and go look it up.
Well, you know, I was going to say I'm not a female, but...
No. It's not that. Go YouTube, how to defend yourself against a banana. And you will find what I'm referring to. If you don't know these guys, watch their stuff. You will know these guys. Everyone knows these guys. Yeah.
All right. So the Shadowblade is coming out.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, yeah.
Shadow on Blade. The Kunkka, right. Yeah. Shadowblade, right.
Yeah. I'm saying it, man. I'm saying it.
Well, that's very fantastic, Toby. I'm glad we're on the same page on this one.
Hey, I'm still here with DOTA, man. I'm still here with DOTA. We're just mixing things up a little bit, you know?
Yeah, a little bit of bananas here and there.
That's sometimes even a grapefruit. Anyway.
Now that one's way out there. I have no idea what you could possibly be referencing with that one, but I won't delve into it.
It's the same thing! God damn it, people are gonna go watch Monty Python. You're too young, Clairvoyance. You're just too young.
Thank you.
Werner, just being enchanted up for a little bit. He's waiting for a hook line. That's all he's waiting for. He wants to hook up, and
a Blueberry Ninja.
Now he can do it. He's in range. He's got to get the line and X. Oh, what the hell? Hook went that away. Gawardio is going to get stunned up because the Spike Carapace after he ended up throwing out a little extra damage. And then BKB up on the blue banana, chasing down Hawaii Yo-O. And the Cogs just keep pushing back Sky. And they'll search further. Werner, the Enchantress Imp still doing their work. Darkseer Wall vacuum back in again. And just attack. They need more damage. And they had just enough. They get three heroes for nothing.
Yeah, that was a really close call. Right in the nick of time would he have been able to TP out. There was no crit coming out of the PA as well, so that didn't help their cause. But yeah, with the Iron Shell as well as the right clicks, that was just a really good fight coming out of them. And TCM whipping a couple of their core spells didn't really help. So not only do they lose a couple kills along with track, but they're going to lose the Rosh unless they buy back and try to do something about it. Now the story has changed.
Mm-hmm. Gotta try and contest it, man. Just for an update too, if you don't want spoilers, then block your ears right now. There has been a result for our last game of the day, and this actually doesn't, of course, have any bearing on this game whatsoever, because neither of these teams were able to achieve a win. But Dignitas as well as VP, their match has completed, and Virtus Pro, they did take the win. So Virtus Pro will go through in the first position. Liquid have already have advanced as well in Group 1's first position. And Region has died next to a Centaur. And that's putting you up to date.
I was just about to say Region has died, just because I knew you would say Region has died.
Region can die. A slow, horrible, horrible death.
Mm-hmm.
The Bounty Hunter died!
Yeah, there we go. Excellent.
David Everett's called Region.
So the VH goes down, but I don't think, looking at their movements, they're not, they want to
go
fight
for
this.
Yep, buy back, in they go. Go Audio goes in, Viz backed inside that inside the tower range. What a stun by Alex. He actually managed to pick up two in the rear end, including a YEOO, but he got bobs up the Meg. Laguna Blade is going to fly out. He couldn't find a target for it. Or at least he could. He just never got it off in time, and now Queen of Pain. Nice. Wonderful ulti, but better mech. Uebelst, they've just got so much more power during these team fights. It's a double kill now for Sky. And Blueberry Ninja forced to TP himself away to safety. SD also back to base safely too. But they lost a hell of a lot during that fight. What, one buyback coming out from a claw from a Bounty Hunter?
Yeah.
Realized the clockwork actually bought back beforehand too, so...
Yeah, that's right. And if those losses weren't enough, just looking at the gold graph, how it has dipped back into the dire favor. I say back, but looks like the majority of the game, Radiant had the upper hand, although it was never a huge advantage going upwards to 2k, maybe 2.5 at best. And yeah, it just comes down to probably the Bounty Hunter lane factor, the fact that one hero was getting complete free farm where the other one wasn't getting any. But that's obviously been being dealt with as we speak right now with all these track kills coming into play. And yeah, the track played an important part, not only as the extra gold, but also they were able to catch out Audio in his Shadow Blade because the track had happened prior to.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a rather significant deal in that fight.
Well, now I'm wondering if Uebelst can really capitalize on this. They've still got to push out. Both teams have got all their tier 2 towers remaining. But Uebelst, they need to get themselves inside the base. Without that, they cannot win. And the longer this game goes on, they found him. Blueberry Ninja, mana burned. He's still got the haste rune on him, but he's not quite sure. Vac tried to hold him there a little bit longer. The track is on him, so they know what's going on. And now, wow, Lina tried to help out and got herself caught. Maybe even more, too, if they ended up seeing where the SD was. And Go Audio should be very, very cautious here on the bottom lane.
Mm-hmm. You know what? I actually don't know what Lina was doing there. She lingered around for way too long. Had dropped her stun like 3 seconds after the Queen had already blinked out. So I feel like she kind of just gave away a free kill. And that's not what you want to do at this point in the game. Of course, it wasn't a track kill, but it's still still another kill in favor of Uebelst Gaming. And after that kill, I feel like they should have just gone for Rosh. But they decided not to. They decided to push out the bottom. And looking at the hero's movements right now, it might be right now that the timing is for them. No, never mind.
I don't know. I don't know if Uebelst is really ready for this just yet. Next Assassin's still farming up. I assume Alex wants his Blink Dagger, but he's going to take some time before he gets there.
Yeah. And the Rosh is getting scouted up by TCM, so they kept their eyes open for it anyway.
We haven't gone in yet. It wouldn't take that long. Like, it really wouldn't take PA that long. If someone, like, purchased up a Vlad's, then it would take him no time whatsoever.
Mm-hmm. And actually, speaking of Vlad's, I didn't talk about the next item in progression for the PA. The Demon Edge is up. It's probably going to be an MKB just because it synergizes so well with the Phantom Strike. The extra mini stuns really, really come into play. And of course, MKB being the single item that gives the most damage, just flat out damage aside from Divine Rapier, a definite smart choice.
Well, still waiting for that push to come. See, but you're going to wait for this Monkey King bar to come. Is it really going to be, like... Is it going to be enough? Like, you get the Monkey King bar up and running, but by the time the Blue Banana has it, it's not that far off, like 600 or so gold. But by the time he's got that, like, Clockwork is inching towards having his Aghanim Scepter. Queen of Pain is very, very close to having his Scythe of Vice. BKB is on the run for Kunkka. And we all know how fast the Kunkka can farm, especially if there's, like, a double creep wave coming his way. your Shadowblade Torrent and Timebringer it out. And you basically got yourself an extra 500, 600 gold almost instantly. This is one of those things where I'm worried that Uebelst will take too long before they try and make a play. And the longer they wait, the stronger TCM gets. And I still feel like TCM's late game factor, even with that PA on the field, once PA is hexed up, evasion doesn't work. You can hit directly into that one. And Queen of Pain's already got a lot of burst damage up his sleeve as it is. And then you got Kunkka. He's going to have his big hit. He is going into BKB. I kind of would have preferred to see him just go with a Crystallis and then go into his BKB, but he's got a little bit more safety. But TCM, like, now they'll scout out. Oh, actually, no, they won't. The rocket went the wrong way.
Oh, dear. Yep, that's the Fiegus.
Yeah, actually, no, the ping came out from SD. They realized that because the rocket flew over the jungle, and they realized the jungle's not dead. And if the jungle's not dead, and all of Uebelst are missing, there's two options. One, Roshan, here comes the rocket. And two, they were smoke ganking. But now they also realize the status of Roshan, and there is just nothing they can do. So yes,
They were just way, way far out of position. As a matter of fact, I was wondering if they would just transition into a very, very strong tier 2 tower push at top. But I think TCM, they're just too worried, and they don't want to fight Uebelst Gaming right now, especially with the Aegis on board. There's no way they can beat a fight against all those face rush with the track and the Nyx Assassin and all that jazz. So Alex is very close to his Blink Dagger. His initiation is going to be crucial because, once again, they rely a lot on burst damage to kill off the Queen of Pain. Like, we've seen every single fight, Toby, she just blinks out because there's not much stuns coming out of Uebelst Gaming. But when they get the initiation on her, it's safe to say that she is somewhat squishy in terms of armor.
Yeah. We're going tower trade time, man. Tier 2 for Tier 2 looks to be the case. At this point, though, TCM definitely has a head start with the creep wave. Especially having a catapult already at the tower. And that means already a TP coming back. Region tries to come up. Nice timing for the Torrent. Actually kept the creep wave away and slows it down. So they got more time to attack on the tower. And Sky, well, X-Mark spots just go audio wanting to hit on the creep wave. Very defensive. He's worried that Uebelst was there. That's what he was concerned about. But Uebelst is actually on the bottom lane attacking down this tier 2 tower. And now they are TPing back. TCM comes back. SD is the only one to do it, though. Throws the poison up. Tries that bit of a looky-looky. And Clockwork. Wonderful latch.
and the climatic, but yet wonderful latch. And
now they go in.
There we go.
They realize Clockwork ulti is down. They can hold him in position. There's already the Hex up on the Lina. And Blue Banana instantly focuses down. Did not want to deal with that burst damage. Just one to the next. BKB is up. Sentry Ward goes down. Two underneath the towers. They can see go audio. They'll need a secondary one. And there it is. Coup de Grace plus the Enchantress Impetus. And that's 3 heroes on the sidelines for TCM. And Uebelst have the best opportunity now to attack onto the tier 3 tower on the bottom lane. The creep wave's about to come in. They've got all the power in the world. They've got Aegis the Immortal. And they could just even dive for kills. That's exactly what Blue Banana is doing.
Yeah.
He's also going to realize that, tower just... Yeah, man. That thing. Okay, now it can be attacked. Gonna wait for that creep wave, you know.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
It's Aghanim's. It's just throwing it to keep the creep wave out. That's all it is. Buy some time for Kunkka to get alive again. Because they've still got Laguna Blade too, so if Uebelst do try and overextend themselves here, then they can easily just pop to the magical damage.
Yep. So Queen of Pain with the Aghanims, the ultimate is very expendable. Only a 40-second cooldown, just longer than one creep wave's worth of spawning. And is Werne going to go for this again? No. He rocketed to scout them, but he's only cogging defensively. If he had actually gone for a big play there, he would have made it because they're all solo HP. But never mind that thought, actually, because PA would have probably ripped him apart.
Might be low HP, but when you get an Aegis Immortal, you got a way to grant all of your HP and mana back again.
Pretty much.
So we said 34, 53, and 15 to 26 on the board. And the advantage is getting bigger and bigger for Uebelst. 7,500 as far as experience goes. And gold, not as high. It's only 3 and a bit, which is kind of surprising when you got a bounty hunter on your team.
Yeah, and it just goes to show that TCM has been doing a good job at keeping the game even, especially after the start and all the team fights that they've lost. I'm actually surprised that it's 15 to 26 and Yeah, I'm surprised that they didn't lose so many more kills. I think a lot of the credit
the CS,
does go to...
man. Look at the CS. Like, you get 214 up on the Quap and 175 on the Kanka. They're finding a lot of farm on this map.
Yep. Those two heroes definitely a lot better at flash farming than most other heroes in this game, bar the darks here. But, yeah, a lot of, with regards to kills, a lot of the credit really does go to Werner. He's involved in 13 out of 15, and a lot of them were solo kills just on his part. So with that said, the smoke rotation is coming out, and are they going to be able to catch one, or is Iron Man going to be safe? And it looks like Iron Man is going to be safe.
Right up to the high ground.
Yeah. Did you hear the hook?
I heard the hook. Yeah.
Yeah. So if they know, I mean, by Uebelst, if they know this, then that's, once again, it's going to be a free tower for them. But regardless, I don't think they're scared of taking a fight.
The clockwork hook sound, I believe, is actually global for everyone.
Ah, all right. So
I might be mistaken on that one, but I'm pretty sure it's actually a global sound. One, oh man, the hex is up. Region, I know he wants to jump, but he needs to be further away from the cogs before Blue Banana, is going to jump in on that one. Screw him. Tier 3 tower down at half life. The walls deliver defense. The Agassi model will pop, but they're fine with that one. Alex, less off the mana burn. Where's a follow-up stun? Can't really do it just yet. Stun's still on cooldown. Not to mention the ship just destroys him. And now, Blue Banana can try and fight this one up. Wurne to go down. Back in again. And Blue Banana's going to be really careful. Laguna Blade as well as the Torrent. They're really extending themselves in so deeply right now, including Edie. Kunk is right behind him, giving him a double kill. And now Sky wants out again, but so does the Darkseer. Trying to pop a smoke in the middle of this one, but that's not going to work, especially when the cog's in a holder in position. And now Uebelst. Advantage. TCM. They easily take that fight.
Wow, that was possibly one of the biggest overextends I've seen in a while. Especially because the PA was so content on dying, just to lose the Aegis and come back. But as that happened, Uebelst clumped up their heroes to try and do damage on the heroes that were killing the PA, which they shouldn't have, because they should have just let the PA die, and then when they come back, they would have initiated all together. With the Darkseer wall and Nyx Assassin stun, they would have wiped TCM. But TCM got the better hand with positioning, because they are inside their base, landed a huge Torrent and an even bigger boat, and they were able to secure a lot of kills. Yeah, so 19 to 28 now, and they picked up a lot of what they had lost.
Yep. They even took the gem during the middle of that fight too. I don't know if you were just watching Bounty as well as Nyx. They were really thinking about going on Queen of Pain after she threw her ulti to take out the creep wave. And then instantly they saw the clockwork coming and start attacking on the tower while they backed out. They realize the clockwork now with his big vision, not to mention his 2k life points, is very difficult to next to impossible to stop. He's 100 gold away from having his full Aghanims.
Yeah, exactly. It's so close. When that Aghanims comes out, he's going to be able to spam out that that hookshot a lot more. And we saw the control that hookshot even did just against the PA. As soon as PA came back with BKB, he was able to hookshot the PA and keep him in his place for like 1.5 to 2 seconds. Mm-hmm. And it just did so much work because it was all during BKB time and she was tanking the tower as well as a whole bunch of other heroes and all that. So it was really, really nicely done out of them.
Smoke movement coming right now. They can rotate up towards the top lane, kind of hoping they'll see Blueberry Ninja, but their observer wall would have seen Blueberry Ninja continuously walk up north. So they realize he's up here somewhere. But they're going to move everybody up here to try and find him. Inside that smoke, moving as fast as possible. And there's a hex. That's a lot of damage. That's a lot of very quick damage.
Pretty much, man. When they're so prepared for a kill like that with the smoke, they have one agenda to find the kill. And needless to say, they found it. 100 to 0 that target. And back to farming for the PA. Is she going to go for a Satanic?
I would assume so. With the amount of damage you do, it's basically like having cheese. But this is something which, really, I'm wondering if Uebelst realized just how good a position they got themselves into just then. They're going to lose it right now with Resolution dying in the middle lane. There's no doubt about that one. Unless Clockwork misses his latch, which he just did. X-Mark spot, Torrent going to bring him up. Cogs might have to be used. In fact, they will be used, and Laguna Blade as well. But Queen of Pain had no buyback. It's 3 minutes until buyback on a Queen of Pain. Track comes out. Blink. Stun. Sky. He should have himself a Shuri toss as well to make sure that SD just remains there. In fact, he waited. He waited it out for the Ghost Scepter so he'd have the extra bonus damage too. And now coming out of that, they get themselves a kill for the buyback of the Darkseer. Maybe they kind of felt that Roshan was a minute sooner than this, but still. Down that middle lane they go.
Oh, they most certainly will. With the Shadow Demon being down for another 40 seconds, this is a mid tower and possibly a Roshan if they're keeping their eyes on it. Of course, it will probably be an engagement there just as the Shadow Demon comes up. But yeah, without a doubt, the mid tower will go down. And if, audio. Yeah, I'm glad he gave up that because what he was going to do, you know, he's trying to hit the creep wave with the Shadow Blade and X himself back. Could have been pretty dangerous.
But with Werner able to just jump himself in at the same time, he should have had the backup. Because Werner was just sitting a little bit further south with a good clean line. And they're moving to Roshan now. But still early, 40 seconds before Roshan will be up and running. As we get more and more items, wards in fact now, coming up for TCM.
Speaking of the ward vision, I'm surprised TCM have the wards placed at where they are actually placed at. It's that one right there that you just circled. I don't even remember that one being placed, so I completely overlooked it. It's a pretty nice positioning because they won't see smoke ganks, but most of the time if you don't see heroes rotating around that general area, you can assume that there is a smoke or some sort of activity going on.
Roshan time now. 41-41 on the dot.
Oh man, I feel like TCM should have been a lot more prepared for this than they are, because as it looks,
they're split.
Yeah.
It's like they're almost happy to fight up against Negus. Rocketfly is just like, oh. The biggest problem they will have right now is if someone randomly just jumps and saying, I got this! Not gonna happen. Satanic is also now up. Surprisingly, though, takes the Satanic as well as the Aegis of the Immortal. It's like they say, you know what, PA? Just win this for us. Screw the rest of the team. You don't need a team. Just win this for us.
Yep, PA is a pretty definite hero for 1v5. And as you said, with the theory of the other team, was it TCM that took the Aegis that way, or... Mm-hmm. Oh, no, VP. You mentioned when I commented on how the Templar didn't take it as opposed to the Naga Siren. Yeah, it's just like, the carry is the most important hero, and in this game especially, the PA is the lifeline of Uebelst Gaming. If the PA goes down, there's no way they have enough teamfight sustainability to do enough damage to the Kunkka as well as the Queen.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's understandably so that they would give the Aegis to the PA.
Well, actually, they do still have the Bounty Hunter, though. Like, Bounty just picked up a Basher, he's got his Vlads and BKB, you've got Naganim, Scepter up on Enchantress, and then you've got to add into effect, like, that's pure damage with a very long range coming in from Enchantress.
Right. Well, the real fear I have for is that Enchantresses generally, even with the extra Aghanim range, if you don't have somebody tanking for you in front, especially heroes like Clockwork and Queen, they can just go on her and she can get bursted down rather quickly. So I think Uebelst, they're definitely ahead with the Aegis as well as the BKB and all the Satanic and everything else. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, they do have to be careful because we saw how badly they had overextended at that top fight earlier. And if that happens again, man, that could be just the ticket they're giving to TCM to say, come back into this game.
Well, see if the ticket can be punched. Uebelst, they're about to try and punch through that bottom lane. Blue Banana's already here, ready to rock and rumble. Enough money for a buyback as well if he needs to. Whereas that Aegis, the Immortal of his, is going to be the scary thing for TCM. And in comes the creep wave. Centaur as well. Not much of an army here at all, in fact, Edie. It's minimal to nothing. Track, Blink, they already got on the SD. Can they kill him off? Yeah, they do. Blink straight in, into the BKB. The Hex up on Blueberry Ninja, back into the wall as well. The YOO also having a great time, and now Werner locked him. Neck charge to pop off, and there's your PA. Well, at least there was also the other hero the PA jumped onto. X-Mark Spot tries to bring him back, and he's just going to keep going. This is that will to die. Whoa! Lina! She was so beautiful and died so young. And now Blueberry Ninja gonna blink himself away back in again. This is gonna be a camping up inside the base now. They will take the tier 3 tower in the bottom lane, take the bottom racks, and then just head into the middle lane. If anybody tries to come out to contest this like this, they will just kill her.
Yeah, just like that, the queen will go down. She does have buyback, so there it is. But once again, without the ultimate, she does have the sheep stick, but 1v5 or 2v5 even, it's just not going to be enough, especially the damage coming out of Uebelst is just too much at this point. Mm-hmm. As you said, man, this is bottom Raxxus. I'd be surprised if they don't rotate to the mid with all their urn charges. So,
rotate
here it is.
Mid. Not to mention the Satanic and still with an Aegis the Immortal. And that Aegis the Immortal still got just under 3 minutes left on it. There is no reason whatsoever to go back. The only reason I would accept is everyone is dead. Or you were trying to feed a courier. That would be also another thing, because for some reason the Dire Courier is now sitting inside the base. Blue Red Ninja jumps away. Impetus, though, goes to work. Has to pop the Hex, and then Hex return. Back in, and then the jump in. Right onto the SD. Disrupts himself, thinking about it. Coup de grace definitely hurting like hell, and don't dive the fountain yet. Dive in the fountain with this. Oh, one. Quapaldi will fly, and now there's actually two heroes from Uebelst on the sidelines. But Wone is also locked into a corner with the blue banana. Gems on the deck, jump down, looking for the coup de grace again, but not going to happen. X marks the spot, bit of a mistiming there on the torrent. And he wants to blink himself away, but remember Satanic. You can just turn around and gain all your life back out again almost instantly. As a piglet though, very difficult to attack. And this also means Satanic's on cooldown. But it does mean he's going to come back to life again with full life, full mana. And then who's he want? Blinks up away from the other two heroes. Goes straight into go audio. Blueberry Ninja also going to be very, very cautious about this. Because there's extra support. Give him an iron shell. Give him something. Impetus damage onto SD. Forcing him out of the lane. Melee Rax is still not down just yet. ED's taking care of it. And there's your jump in again. Nice Ghost Scepter. Keeps him alive and back to safety. And now Disruption over on the side. It's again ED this time around getting called out. And now Uebelst can fall back. They've taken a Rax and a half here. They know that Blueberry Ninja's on the hump. One blink to ulti, and he could have actually had RMN there.
As a matter of fact, I think the tables have turned. They're going to go in to kill Blueberry Ninja now. If he doesn't blink, Blueberry Ninja might very well die here.
He doesn't blink. Stand up, jump in, and the blue banana strikes again.
Yeah, so 30 seconds on the Kunkka, 80 seconds on the Queen. Toby, I think this is every set of Raxes.
Mm-hmm. Stumpy.
Makes his entrance into the game.
Yeah. His bark is worse than his...
Well, the PA greeted him with a 1.6k crit damage. I mean, I know the courier recently churned immortal, but just not enough to withstand the coup de grace.
The PA will also greet him with an abyssal blade in a moment. And there's a heart recipe on the courier of the dire side. And in fact, it's a full heart for RMN.
Wow. As if he wasn't difficult enough to kill already. There he is. Four set of items with the gem and the bottle. He is looking scary. And he did a lot of work this game too with all the surges he gave to his team. And if you notice in that team fight too, there are a lot of times where the PA actually got kills while she was stunned because she did so much damage, didn't finish them off, but the Iron Shell finished off the job. So RMN is really on top of the ball right now with his Iron Shell usage. And his spell usage overall with Sheep Sticks are really, really helping the team fights.
Mm-hmm. To a point where PA can be... It's a good thing he's got an Agonim Scepter.
What can I say? He's had some really amazing hooks this game.
Oh, it's
he's
a jump. He's coming in right now. Werner, yep, he's inside the cogs, and Blue Banana just does not care. Piglet might care. Laguna Blade can be thrown as well, but look for the Satanic to pop. In fact, there it is. Blue Banana already up to full life, battling inside the Darkseer wall. Never a place you're going to win a fight. Go Audio wants to run, but he only runs to his own grave. And the two supports stay back in base saying, not for my carry. No. I wish to live. I wish to... 1800? I saw 1800 then. Yeah, 1813. And that's going to be GG. And that's going to end our coverage for tonight. Remember, peoples, tomorrow at 10 in the morning, CEST time, that is. Na'Vi will play up against one of the BYOC teams. That is the first game right here on this live stream, starting tomorrow. So that should be some good fun. Cater Gaming, as well as... what was the other one I mentioned?
Na'Vi, Cater...
Impunity. As well as Cater Gaming will be the two BYOC teams playing tomorrow. They will... we'll be following them throughout the entire Group C and Group D, then casting in quarterfinal matches, also appearing here, whatever game that the DreamHack stream doesn't cast, we'll be streaming it out for you, so you make sure you don't miss out on any of the DreamHack Dota, and then on the Monday, you'll go over to twitch.tv/DreamHackDota to watch from there, because there will be no live stream coming out from here, only one English stream per game, that is the rules, the laws. How we govern ourselves. And that is going to be the end of our day. Clairvoyance Man, big thank you as well for joining me today. Very much appreciated.
It was most absolute pleasure on my part. I mean, there were some fantastic games as we had seen, and some had to rise to the quarters, the others had to fall. But no worries, fellas, because there's more interesting Dota coming out, as Toby said, tomorrow and the day after. If that's not enough for you, there's plenty more coming after, so just stay tuned. Stay touched.
Hell yeah. Thanks for watching, peoples. We're going to wrap it up for tonight. If you want to stick around, the rebroadcast will begin. Yes, it will have all the breaks in it, which is going to be a bitch. But hey, that's the world of Landota. You can just enjoy the tunes anyway. Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.